Welcome to Babunga's channel. If you want to know how you can make a beautiful old-fashioned scrimshaw box out of a cat food tin and polymer clay, stay with me until the end of this video. First of all, feed the cat and clean the tin very well. Also, straighten the lid. This log is about a pack of polymer clay. I used opaline white and translucent. Cut a fifth of it and roll the rest to make it longer. Now flatten it to turn it into a flat, thin strip like this. Put it aside and turn your attention to the smaller piece of clay. Work it into a thin flat disc. Turn the tin upside down and smear a little amount of liquid polymer clay. Place the disc and press very well all around, covering the bottom of your tin. Go around like this and then trim all around the edge. Now that the bottom is covered, apply liquid polymer clay all around the side of the tin. Get the flat thin strip of clay and place it carefully, covering all around the side. Cut and bring the ends together. As you work, try not to cover the beautiful golden rim. If you do, just trim with your knife. Work some more to connect the two parts of polymer clay at the seams. And this is it. Now, of course, you can roll a little bit on the table to distribute clay evenly. Okay, I guess there is enough clay left to also cover the top of the lid. Don't bother to cover the underside. And here is our box. And now comes etching time. You can use anything to carve and stamp motifs that have to do with sea and the sea life. There is so much of it. You can do fish, shells, seaweeds, bubbles, anchors, boats, nets, all of that, or as many as you like. Do all around the side, and you can also do the bottom, and don't forget the lid. I'm going to do a big fish here, surrounded with bubbles and other shapes. Use anything to help you achieve this look. And by no means all these carvings, stampings, and etchings have to be perfect. They only need to cover all the clay surfaces. After you finish, check all around and bottom, and it's time for dark brown acrylic paint. Apply generously so the paint gets inside the grooves. Do that all around, and then with a wet wipe, take the paint away. Removing the paint this way reveals all the beautiful etchings that you've done. It's only polymer clay, but it looks like carved ivory or bone. Now, take the tin and its lid to the oven, and after baking, let it cool down. Now, we are ready to work a little more on the inside and on the underside of the lid. First, we'll cover this sharp inner edge using gold polymer clay that we made into a thin cord. As always, apply liquid polymer clay before fitting the cord in there. Press all around and then cut to remove excess cord. After fitting the raw polymer clay ring in there, bake the tin again and cover the messy underside of the lid with a golden paper circle. You can use gloss varnish after baking the tin, and this was how you can make a beautiful old-fashioned scrimshaw box out of a cut food tin and polymer clay.